from Creamer Media in Johannesburg, this is the Real Economy Report. Vodacom has officially launched its standards-based commercial fifth generation of 5G service in Lesotho, delivering early access technology initially to two enterprise customers, with ambitions of eventually launching the service commercially in South Africa. Natasha Urdendal tells us more.
Vodacom showcased the potential of 5G after launching a commercial service in Lesotho earlier this month. Using 3.5 GHz spectrum, the company will initially provide fixed wireless access broadband services to two enterprise customers in Lesotho. Vodacom Group CEO Shamil Yusup explains.
Why it's special is that it's the first commercial launch of 5G anywhere in the continent. And it was important for us to really be at the cusp of this new technology so that we can also learn as it progresses. And obviously in the coming weeks and months, the technology will evolve. There'll be new devices that will basically give us the full benefits of 5G as we go forward. So being there at the cusp of this is really important to get the learnings and so on. So we're thankful to the two customers that have basically worked with us, but we're also thankful to our supplier, Huawei, in terms of working with us to be able to launch the first commercial launch. It's also telling that one of the smallest countries in Africa is the first. And I think that's quite a momentous thing for the Kingdom of Lesotho.
However, the same service cannot be launched commercially in South Africa until the required spectrum is allocated. Vodacom South Africa only has been granted a temporary spectrum license of 100 MHz in the 3.5 GHz band to showcase the 5G network capabilities.
To the regulators in all the countries in Africa, including South Africa, let's not get left behind. We've always been at the forefront of the launch of, firstly, remember, 2G, we were one of the first countries in the world to launch the GSM technology. We were among the first in launching 3G. We made a plan with 4G and we refarmed spectrum to be able to do it. Unfortunately, with 5G, there isn't plans that you can make. The spectrum is very specific that's required. With the slowdown in the digital migration, or the digital migration not happening, I think there's an opportunity to, whilst we're waiting for that to happen, to leapfrog, because the 5G spectrum is there. Let us be among the leading countries in the world when it comes to 5G technology.
The group's service in South Africa delivers speeds in excess of 700 megabits a second, which will surpass 1 gigabit a second as new software versions and devices become available, and latencies of less than 10 milliseconds.
The demonstrations you see here today are some of the stuff we built to demonstrate 5G. Now behind me you see racing cars, and you could think, what has racing cars got to do with 5G? In 5G, one of the most important things is latency, and latency is how quickly something reacts. So a second latency means you say 1 and I say 2. If it's comma 1 or comma 01 seconds latency, it's much, much faster. And in the 5G world, latency is very important for things like autonomous cars. In an autonomous car, if it must make a decision, it can't wait a second or two to decide if it must swerve to avoid a pedestrian or obstacle. It must make that decision nearly instantaneously. So we need low latency. We talk about sub 10 milliseconds. But how do you demonstrate latency to people? So what we've built here behind me are racing seats where you drive a car around a track, or you can drive a car on a road, and then we introduce latency that's normal today onto the steering wheel. So the person is driving the car and is doing maybe quite well, and suddenly we introduce 50 or 60 or 80 milliseconds of latency onto that steering wheel, and suddenly they can't control the car. And it's a very real effect. It's not so easy to see when you watch them, but when you sit in the seat and you turn the steering wheel and suddenly the car doesn't react, it's like you've got five or six drinks in you. It would be the same kind of effect. So latency is super important, and the racing seats is a very nice way to in real time demonstrate latency and show why 5G is required for autonomous cars in the future.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy.